Welcome to the 32nd Annual Port Hope Civic Awards Ceremony. I'm York Bellsmith, your MC for this special presentation. This is the first virtual Civic Awards Ceremony in the history of Port Hope. On behalf of the entire municipality, I thank you for tuning in. It is my great honor to be returning to the Civic Awards stage, albeit virtually and with the same hair I had back in 1980. Tonight we recognize a wide variety of individuals and groups for their praiseworthy contributions, accomplishments, and achievements that make the municipality of Port Hope a great place to live, work, and play. At this time, on behalf of the Civic Awards Committee and Port Hope Council, I invite Mayor Bob Sanderson to say a few words to kick off this exciting celebration.
Hello, Port Hope. Mayor Bob Sanderson here, trusting you are well. And thank you, York, and welcome everybody. It's my great pleasure to acknowledge and celebrate the outstanding contributions and achievements of our 2019 Civic Awards recipients. Now in its 32nd year, the Civic Awards have become a highlight of our annual calendar, providing much deserved recognition to our community's unsung heroes. The Civic Awards program recognizes the broad range of elements that make up Port Hope's inspiring culture by acknowledging those who contribute time, talent, and resources towards improving the quality of life in our community. This evening, we will recognize a wide assortment of individuals and groups for their exceptional citizenship across 8 award categories. And congratulations to all those who were nominated, and our sincere thanks to those who also took out the time to make a nomination. Without you, our nominators, there would be no Civic Awards. Thank you for joining us as we virtually present some very special awards. I'd now like to turn the microphone over to York, and thank you, York, for emceeing.
Thanks, Mayor Sanderson. At this point in the ceremony, we would normally acknowledge outstanding citizens and youth of the past in the live theater audience. This year, we would like to share with you an image listing the previous recipients of these prestigious awards. Stay tuned, as later on tonight, we will name the Outstanding Citizen and Youth of 2019. Let's begin the awards presentation with our first category, Community Service. The Community Service Award recognizes individuals or groups that have a leadership role or positively impacted the community with their actions. The volunteer efforts of the recipients in this category create experiences, programs, and services that our citizens have come to rely on. Our first recipients are John and Lynn Selinsky. They have run the weekly Port Hope Cruise Night for the past 5 years. This gathering of vintage cars is a social event for many proud car owners and aficionados, drawing participants from across the area. John and Lynn work to arrange weekly door prizes and manage the event's Facebook page. The Port Hope Cruise Night is one of the largest continuous car events in the area. Thank you, John and Lynn, for keeping this tradition going. Our next recipient is Noreen Dat Sukram. Mr. Sukram initiated the Canada 150 Pay It Forward project, where he assisted 150 people, including immigrants and international students living in Port Hope, find employment. Through this initiative, he reviewed resumes, helped prepare individuals for job interviews, all at no cost. What a gesture. Mr. Sukram is described as inclusive, non-judgmental, and passionate about making a difference in the world. Our next recipient is Janet Waddington. Janet used her passion and knowledge to serve the Canadian Firefighters Museum as collections manager. Her focused, organized approach shaped how the museum's collection was documented and archived, which included documenting 35 years of records. When the museum closed, Janet helped photograph, group, and move the entire collection. Her hands-on enthusiasm also had her assisting with many of the museum's events, such as the Toy Boat Show, Walk of Fame, and preparing floats for the local parades. Sadly, Janet passed in January 2020. The museum board and the municipality of Port Hope are grateful for the opportunity to honor her tonight. Our next recipient is Don McNeil. Community events have been a constant throughout Don's volunteer history. Since his retirement from the Port Hope Kinsmen, Don still works the Canada Day Parade each year, coordinating and leading family members to collect donations. In 2019, he supported the Jurassic Park event in Memorial Park, making sure the site setup, event flow, and public safety was as smooth as a swish. Don is known for stepping up when needed, and we thank him here tonight for his ongoing volunteer efforts. And our next recipient is Al Wilson. Al Wilson served on the Civic Awards Advisory Committee for 4 years before passing the torch. He rolled up his sleeves to undertake numerous bylaw reviews and offer creative suggestions for ceremony entertainment. He also implemented the tradition of the Port Hope Pipe Band performing on the street outside the theater before the show. We thank Al for his dedication to this program. And our next recipient is Robert True. An active volunteer since 1977, Bob True is known for giving his tenacious focus to many community initiatives. He established and helped build the first baseball facility in Garden Hill and further the ice rink, which he helped maintain for local families and hockey teams to enjoy. Bob spent 2 decades running the canteen fundraiser at the Garden Hill rink with proceeds going to local causes. Thank you, Bob, for generously giving of your time and energy over the years. Our next recipient is David Doherty. Tonight we honor David's long history of volunteerism in Port Hope. In the 1970s, 80s, and 90s, David served the Parks, Recreation, and Culture Department, assisting in organizing youth events and maintenance for the sports fields in Port Hope. David has put in volunteer hours as a minor hockey coach, with the Aquatic Club, local archives, and helped establish the Athletic Wall of Honor. Thank you, David. Our next recipient is Barry Lee Adamson Price. Barry Lee has been with the first Port Hope Scouts since 2014, first as a Beaver leader, then moving up to Cubs. She is deeply committed to her role bringing new ideas and helping nurture the development of youth. Her dedication and flexibility have her jumping into covering meetings, braving the elements at winter camp, and hosting the Cub group on her property to ensure varied outdoor experiences. BL embodies the spirit of scouting, and we are pleased to celebrate her many years of service. Our next recipient is Lori Stevenson Britton. You might be familiar with Lori's smiling face from her work at local libraries, but after hours, Lori is an active volunteer dedicated to raising Port Hope's profile through celebrating the anniversary of the first wheat harvest in Port Hope. This initiative brought Port Hope provincial and federal recognition as a pioneer agricultural community in early Ontario. Lori developed the idea, secured funding, compiled research, and established community connections that led to an impressive collaboration. Lori has given hundreds of hours researching and preserving local history, and for that, we thank her. Our next recipient are the Super Sisters. Working with the Community Health Centre of Northumberland, the Super Sisters have been volunteering their services on a weekly basis for 6 years. From 2013 to 2019, these 20 individuals have collectively donated 2,539 hours to help combat food insecurity by preparing homemade soup. The soups are served at the community food cupboard every Thursday afternoon. In 2019 alone, they made over 1,845 soups under the philosophy of limiting food waste, using local produce, and providing quality food to our neighbors. Drum roll, please. It's time to acknowledge and celebrate the Super Sisters. Dorothy Potter, Celia Maris Krangle, Catherine Hublow Rich, Carol Madden, Carol Irwin, Brenda Arend, Betty Beharry Lal, Barbara Clarkson, Ann Harrison, Anna Mae Garrett, Vicky Bobyash, Ursula Whalen, Sharon O'Leary, Sharon Cooksey, Phyllis Smith, Pearl Harris, Olive Climo, Melchora Majorado, Joan Ashton, and Jennifer Willis. Our next two recipients are 11 and 9 years old. Two brothers who know that to be part of a community, you have to do what you can, no matter how small the gesture, to make other people's lives better. Please join me in celebrating Owen and Lachlan Price. These two have grown up volunteering with various local organizations, including the Hope Agricultural Club and Float Your Fanny Down the Ganny. For the past 3 years, they have also been assisting with the Remembrance Day audio equipment. Every year, their roles grow as they do, and these two exuberant helpers are up for the job. Thank you, Owen and Lachlan, for giving us your ongoing enthusiasm and energy. Our next recipient is Penny Nutbrown. Penny is an inspirational longtime volunteer known for her energy and exceptional organization. Her impact on the community is clear. You just have to mention her name to draw a smile from local youth and an, of course I know Penny, from adults. Today, Penny is being recognized for spearheading the new Repair Cafe series in town. This neighborhood initiative promotes repair over tossing things out by providing 30 voluntary fixers to fix items on the spot at no charge, teaching us all there is a better way. Amazing. Next up on our community service list are the volunteers with the Cameco Capital Arts Center. The Capital Theater relies on a phenomenal group of volunteers. These folks are the goodwill ambassadors of this historic landmark and cultural hub. The volunteers run all the functions of the front office for performances, concerts, and movies at the Arts Center. These dedicated volunteers provide a quality theater-going experience and ensuring a welcoming atmosphere. We'd like to recognize service anniversaries for several committed volunteers tonight. Celebrating 5 years of service is Suzanne Fennessy, Sue Stevens, Eleanor Vardy, Laura Andrews, Flo Rickerby, Judy Vivian, Judy Kerrigan, Ron Bayless, and Terrell Kidman. Next up are five individuals who have given 10 years of service to this theater. Doreen Rossi, Rhoda Bullen, Lynn Liddell, Janice Dilworth, and Felicitas Hansen. Celebrating 15 years of service, our next group of volunteers have exhibited outstanding dedication. Linda Booker, Edward Gottawa, and Margaret Gottawa. Lastly, we extend a special thank you to Rena Watson, Ann Shields, and Selwyn Shields, who have been volunteering with the Capitol Theater for 20 years. Next, we blast this next award over the airways to Northumberland 89.7. This not-for-profit radio station broadcasts everything local. For 6 years, a dedicated team of volunteers have worked to run the business of local radio, providing community content designed for Northumberland, everything from food to farm businesses. Tonight, we honor them for their service in keeping our community informed and entertained. Continuing with our community service category, we are moving along to our next three recipients. Marlene Funster has been a reliable volunteer at the Regency Long-Term Care Home since 2016. There, Marlene has been assisting in the activity department, running crafts and games, much to the residents' delight. Her enthusiastic help at the care home enriches the lives of residents and is a welcome help for staff. Thank you for this compassionate gesture. Darlene and Teddy Taylor. After the passing of Teddy's mother, who was a resident at Regency Manor, Darlene and Teddy continue to visit the home once a week for the past year to engage with the residents. They infuse bingo nights, sing-alongs, and special events with their humor and enthusiasm. Special thanks to Teddy and Darlene for sharing their hearts with the residents and staff. Our next recipient is Nita Daw. With 221 hours of volunteer service, Nita has proven herself to be an exemplary and compassionate member of the TCS community. She has shown a particular interest in tutoring peers and local children through Rebound for Child and Youth Services. She helps with many facets of school life, such as tutoring prospective students through the MassKey program, planning flagship events, and ensuring smooth operations in the school library and drama division. Her enthusiasm and vigor have been a great influence on her peers. Our next recipient is Natasha Pinto. Natasha consistently proves herself as a selfless individual and a leader among her peers. In 18 months, she has devoted 278 hours of her time to volunteering with many local organizations, such as the Beatrice Strong Public School, Lang Pioneer Village, Hope Street Terrace, Extend-A-Care, Forest View Kennels, Cultivate Festival, and the Cancer Society, to name just a few. Phenomenal contribution of time and energy. Congratulations, Natasha. Our next recipient is Jack Zhang. Jack has been volunteering consistently since he first joined the TCS community. Jack has given time to the MasterKey program, Hote Goat Farm, Week Without Walls, Mass Stewardship, and the Trinity Environmental Action Club. Jack has also taken his service to the international stage, partaking on a service trip to Ecuador, where he was highly regarded by his chaperones and colleagues for his work. Our next recipient is Justin Belanger. Throughout his 4 years at Trinity College School, Justin has taken passion for learning and applied it to service, accumulating 325 hours of volunteer work. He has given his energy to Rebound for Youth, Beatrice Strong Science Outreach, the MasterKey Program, Environmental Action Committee, Chapel Choir, and Academic Support Steward. Justin has shown that he is a team player and can rise up, lead, and support others as needed. Thank you, Justin. Next, we have Angie Zhang. Through her volunteer work at TCS and in the community, Angie has proven herself to be a role model, not just to younger students, but also to her peers. She is very giving of her time and expertise. Her volunteer work is extensive, including service with the Salvation Army, Northumberland Humane Society, teaching handbell ringing, stewardship in the arts department, assisting with municipal surveying, an international service trip to Ecuador, and planting trees. Amazing work, Angie. And next we have Victoria Wilson. Victoria is a TCS student and Port Hope local who has donated 178 hours to volunteering. She has participated in a diverse list of initiatives, from internal school programming as an athletic therapy steward to volunteering with both children and animals in the Northumberland community, supporting mental health initiatives, and working to restore local trails. Victoria has shown through her breadth of service commitments that she cares deeply about this community. Tonight, we recognize her for her contributions. It takes many dedicated people to create a strong community, and these recipients tonight are an example to us all. Our second awards category tonight is athletics. The Athletics Award is given to athletes who have placed at a national or provincial championship, qualified for national funding, or chosen to represent Ontario or Canada in a competition. Our first recipient tonight is Charlotte Grimshaw. An accomplished twirler and familiar household name here on the Civic Awards stage, Charlotte is the gold medalist in the Junior B Medley and Junior B Freestyle at the Ontario Baton Twirling Championships. She qualified to compete at the Canadian Championships in July 2019. She is a member of the Camaros Baton Club and in the team competition won 2 gold and 1 silver at the Provincial Championships and gold, silver, and bronze medals at the National Championships. Charlotte is 14, folks, and an annual athletic achiever. And our next athletics award goes to Abigail Tino. Abigail, now 16 years old, has been a competitive swimmer with NORAC for the past 9 years. In 2019, Abby attended the Youth Junior Swimming Championships in Brampton, Ontario, where she received gold in the 100-meter breast, 100-meter fly, and 50-meter freestyle. She took home silver in the 200-meter individual medley and bronze in the 100-meter backstroke. She also received recognition from Swim Ontario and won the Female High Point Award for 16 and over. Quite a collection of medals for Abigail. Congrats on your outstanding athletic performance. Our next awards category is Arts and Culture. The Arts and Culture Award is awarded to individuals or groups for promotion of the arts, high achievement in the arts, and for significant cultural contributions to the community. Our first recipients in the Arts and Culture category is The Breezeway Live. The Breezeway started 5 years ago with some pals sharing some tunes, but it has quickly transformed into so much more. Now it is a weekly studio and broadcast production that provides a platform for aspiring and seasoned entertainers to be seen around the world. Through their visionary efforts, these volunteers, who often wear their hearts on their sleeves, have worked to raise over $20,000 for local charities. Their promotion of the arts and dedication to the community impacts many in the community. The Breezeway team is led by founder Stephen Francis and a group of volunteers. Members of the team include Stephen Francis, Greg Werner, Shane Werner, Fred Warner, Brenda Mills, Tiffany Thompson, Lynn Gowland, Mark Taylor, John Francis Power, Don Mills, and Jamie Rath. Our next Arts and Culture Award goes to Herb Young. Herb is a true champion of the arts and long-standing contributor to the Port Hope Arts Festival. For the past 5 years, Herb has been designing and implementing new programming components for this annual event, such as Art on the Porch, a juried exhibition, Art Around Town, and live theater connections. His efforts helped to expand the festival audience and created new opportunities for the artists to show their work while connecting with one another. Tonight we honor Herb for lending his efforts towards evolving the Port Hope Arts Festival and promoting arts in our community. Our next Arts and Culture Award goes to the Critical Mass Adventure Organizing Committee. This group of volunteers spent months coordinating a unique, fun, and fully engaging festival this past summer in Memorial Park. Festival programming included a live presentation of Dungeons & Dragons, specially curated by Ed Greenwood, where actors, players, and game masters explored a captivating universe together. This high-caliber, interactive event exposed attendees, both new and familiar with this form of gaming, to a world of inclusive and imaginative gameplay. The creative team behind this experience put in hundreds of hours designing exhibits, workshops, and storylines. Let us honor team members who brought the vision to our shared reality. Ed Greenwood, Fiona Krangle, Shannon Gardner, Ted Rouse, Madeline Sinnott, Kelly Kirkham, Brinley Longman, and Alex Kirkham McGriskin. Our next Arts and Culture recipients are Mary Lou Fallis and Ian Montagne. Together, Mary Lou and Ian created a memorable benefit concert in support of the Port Hope ACO's endeavor to sustain and preserve the historic Opera House building. The concert, Prima Donna on a Moose, was as offbeat as its title. It featured music from Canadian composers, well-researched content that referenced the Opera House building as well as Port Hope's own history, while educating and entertaining attendees. This creative concert raised $6,000 for the cause. Our next Arts and Culture Award goes to Patsy Beeson. Patsy has led comprehensive educational programming for the Port Hope chapter of the ACO for 15 years. Since 2009, her quarterly 8-page newsletter has been described as the glue that connects the chapter's membership of over 500 individuals. Patsy started the annual excursions in 2005 to provide educational outings that broaden the cultural knowledge of the membership and introduce them to the standards of heritage conservation being embraced throughout the province. Our last recipients in this category are the team leads for the Port Hope Barn Quilt Trail. In the fall of 2019, the Port Hope Barn Quilt Trail was awarded the Margaret and Nicholas Hill Heritage Landscape Award by ACO Ontario. The initiative was launched in July 2017 as a Canada 150 project and has deepened our collective knowledge of Port Hope's cultural landscape. Taking many months to complete, the project highlights 23 heritage barns throughout Port Hope's two wards. The designs for each barn title carefully considered the property's specific history and the farm's current work. The Barn Quilt Trail is a legacy project that manifested under the artistic leadership of Moya McPhail, Catherine McComb, Lois Richardson, and Pamela Tate. At this time, we would like to introduce the chair of the Port Hope Civic Awards Committee, Carrie Lee Kroger, to say a few words and introduce the next category.
It has been my privilege to be chair of the Civic Awards Advisory Committee for the past 2 years, and if you ask me why I do it, the answer is simple. I cannot express how much joy it gives me every year to read the nominations and learn the extent of work volunteers do in Port Hope every day. And even when I think I have a handle on the work that they do, every year I'm surprised by the new programs and the new faces of volunteers who've chosen to step up and by their level of commitment. We come from a town named Port Hope, and I think these volunteers offer the hope that we so desperately need right now. Thank you, volunteers, for being my hope. Thank you for putting a smile on the faces around you, and thank you for your continued service. This is part of the reason why the Inspiration Award is one of my favorites. These recipients show us how to act in the face of need, that we should act, and maybe most importantly, they propel the innovation of ideas to those around them. I'd like to introduce the Inspiration Award. This is presented to an individual who inspires those around them to serve more, to think bigger. It is presented to someone who encourages action and emboldens those around them to believe in themselves.
I would like to thank Carrie and the entire Civic Awards Committee and Jeannie Maidens for making this event possible in the situation that we're in right now, this virtual Civic Awards ceremony. Our first two recipients of the Inspiration Awards, through their leadership role at JJIU Studio of Dance, are Jennifer Mercer and Katie Tregott. They've been inspiring young dancers to continue their craft, volunteer their time in the community. Jennifer, for the past 20 years, has coached hundreds of students. Her leadership also extends to the management of the I Love Port Hope Facebook page and many local events, including the Police Leafs Alumni Game. And Katie recently created a new program called HURO, an initiative developed to inspire young girls to build each other up and to look at themselves in a positive light. Keep up the inspirational work, ladies. Our next Inspiration Award goes to Stacy Doherty. Stacy is a man that inspires action. He has a long history of volunteerism and fundraising. His work as an advocate for our local schools, including recent work on the Celebrate Port Hope High School event, inspires others to be more aware of what is going on and how they can get involved. Stacy is a community promoter and is constantly looking out for others. He is often and quietly organizing ways to help around the community, including hosting a show to support displaced families of the Wellington Street Fire, music marathons for the food bank, and family fundraisers, as well as so much more. Stacy's passion for this community is inspiring. Our next award is the Agriculture Award, presented to an individual or group who has had an impact in agriculture, has promoted agricultural awareness, and exhibited leadership within the agricultural community in the municipality of Port Hope. Tonight we recognize Burnham Farms Limited, Paul, Ann, and Mark Burnham. Burnham Farms Limited own and lease approximately 1,900 acres of land in Northumberland County. This family-run operation is known as an agricultural institution and has been working the land for centuries. Paul has delivered numerous presentations over the years to impart his insights and experience with local food production. He also hosted a radio show on 89.7 called From Farm to Field, where he discussed local agriculture concerns, successes, and fielded questions from listeners. Mark was featured on a county-produced YouTube video called Cash Crops in Northumberland, where he explains the science behind his farming techniques. He has been instrumental in creating the corn maze that doubles as an interactive learning experience where attendees learn about bees and honey production, a local attraction that has garnered substantial media attention. Ann was a member of the Northumberland Steering Committee for the Regional Local Food Business Retention and Expansion Project, which led to the building of the Ontario Agri-Food Venture Center. For a number of years, Burnham Farms have donated the use of their land to the Hope Agricultural Heritage Club for their annual antique machinery show and crop wheat harvest demonstration. They have exhibited in farm and field crop competitions, receiving numerous first and second prize ribbons over the years. In 2011, Paul and Ann were awarded the Ontario Association of Agricultural Societies Agricultural Achievement Award and the Bank of Montreal Ontario Farm Family Award in 2013. The Burnhams are excellent advocates for the agricultural sector. Their willingness to explore and try new techniques keeps them on the cutting edge of technology and good land stewardship practices. Their hard work, extensive knowledge, and community-mindedness has established them as a trusted voice and known leader in their industry. Our final award category is the Philanthropy Award. This award is given to an individual or group for their outstanding desire to promote the welfare of others through donations of money, goods, talent, or service. Our next recipients are Judy Hone and Phil Redford. They are the leadership team for the charity event Coldest Night of the Year. This annual initiative helps funds outreach at Greenwood Coalition. For the past 5 years, Judy and Phil contributed hundreds of hours coordinating event logistics for over 40 teams. This past year, they were able to exceed their sponsorship goals by 120%, raising over $60,000 at the event. Under their leadership, this initiative has contributed over $200,000 to the services helping vulnerable people in the municipality of Port Hope solve individual housing needs. Thank you, Judy and Phil, for your outstanding philanthropic endeavors. Next up, Cameron Green and Regine Miranda of the Thirsty Goose. Since the opening of this local establishment, Cameron and Regine have been seeking out ways to give back to the community. From collecting food donations for the local Humane Society, donating food to Greenwood Coalition, raising funds for Critical Mass via their weekend brunch buffets, and raising money for the local Skeena Cadets, to name a few. These two are consistently open to working with and supporting the community, using their business to amplify their personal philanthropic efforts. Our last philanthropy award is a double feature. We'd like to honor the Port Hope ACO and the Port Hope Heritage Foundation. They have worked tirelessly together to support, promote, and fund heritage preservation throughout Port Hope. Some of their efforts include the Port Hope House Tour, the Garden Tour, Antiques and Artifacts Auction, working to relocate the Little Station House, supporting the Town Park Gates, and adopting the historic Opera House. These two organizations have collectively restored or assisted in the restoration of numerous properties throughout the municipality and in the heritage business area. In 2019 alone, the ACO donated $134,000 to preservation efforts. The ongoing collaborative work of these two organizations continues to pay benefits all throughout our community today. Congratulations to all of our recipients so far. We have two final awards, our Outstanding Youth and Outstanding Citizen. We were able back in August to hold a special private ceremony to honor these two individuals. We take you to that ceremony now.
So thank you for joining us tonight, and welcome back to Town Hall. Most of us haven't been here for a while, but some of us have been in and about a little bit. So the business at Town Hall has continued, but Town Hall remains closed. We're joined tonight by most of council, properly distanced, and they wanted to be here to observe this momentous occasion. We're going to talk about two individuals this evening, Karen and Spencer. This represents the Outstanding Citizen and the Outstanding Youth. And these we felt were too important to not go acknowledged in a public format. And thank goodness that we're in stage three, so we are able to appropriately acknowledge the contributions these two individuals have made to our municipality. Safety first, especially this day, we thank you for keeping in mind COVID precautions during this event and to continue to wearing your mask. 2020 has proven to be an interesting and challenging year. Our community has had to pivot and adapt. There have been some struggles, but there have also been some triumphs and togetherness within the community. The community has risen to the occasion, and we have set a good example in Ontario and the Northumberland County to keep COVID out of our community, and we'll continue to do so. As you know, we had a civic awards ceremony scheduled, and it was supposed to take place at the Capitol Theater this April, and we had to postpone it. And that was just a sudden postponement. It was a very difficult decision, but was necessary at the time. In light of physical distancing protocols and keeping the safety of our community top of mind, we've now embarked on hosting the first ever virtual ceremony. However, as I said, we could not miss this opportunity to present these two prestigious awards in person and in front of a live audience. That live audience being those people who have participated and would like to acknowledge as well the contributions. So here we are, well under the provincial gathering limit, to safely commemorate this moment. And what an honor it is to share this experience here in Town Hall with all of you. During these times, maybe more than ever, we are faced with considering what it means to be a good citizen, a helpful neighbor, and a community champion. To be a problem solver, a doer and a dreamer. One that takes action, inspires action, and helps keep our community vibrant and connected. It is these motives that set our recipients apart, what elevates them to our outstanding status. Your years of experience, countless hours of your time and energy have been put towards many projects, initiatives, and successes. And for this, we thank you and we celebrate you. Tonight, we honor your contributions and achievements as our outstanding citizen and youth. I'd like to call on our ceremony's MC, York Bell Smith, to the microphone to begin with reading the tributes for the outstanding youth. York.
Thank you, Mary Sanderson. Just do a little cleanup after you here. It's like all over the podium.
The dirty mayor.
Just take care of that too. I know we're not touching the microphone, but thank you very much. It is really an honor to be here, much different than others that I've emceed in the past, of course, as Mayor Sanderson talked about doing it at the Capitol Theater, but it is very, very important that we honor you for the amount of work that you have done to make the municipality of Port Hope a great place to live, from the youth, the adults, and through your life. Thank you very much, and it is an honor to be here to read your tributes. Welcome to the 2019 Civic Awards Special Presentation of Outstanding Citizen and Youth Award. So what's going to happen is I'm going to read your tribute. I'm going to take this off while I'm up here. And then invite you up to accept your award. You have the opportunity to say a few words if you wish. Microphone is here. I will step away and we'll wipe things down in between. Due to physical distancing requirements, we have placed your awards on two different tables. The Outstanding Youth Award is over here for Spencer, for Karen. Outstanding Citizen is over here. All right, we're going to start with our youth tribute. Our 2019 Outstanding Youth's community involvement began at the age of 6. He is now in his graduating year and shows no signs of slowing down. Every year he has made the honor roll and has achieved his French language certificate. He competed in the Waterloo Math Contest and took first prize at the Peterborough Science Fair. In addition to his academics, he is a member of the Port Hope High School's badminton, soccer, swimming, basketball, and track and field teams. After being named the cross country's MVP, top hurdler, and mid-distance runner, he was chosen as the Male Athlete of the Year, garnering the prestigious Pamela Forward Memorial Award. This outstanding youth has dedicated 180 hours to community service. Within the high school, he served as athletics minister, on the student advisory committee, and as a link leader for the past 2 years. Through this, he has helped organize or participate in events like the school's Christmas card sale, Relay for Life, the Terry Fox Walk, Step Up for Mental Health as well. Outside of the school, Spencer has volunteered with the Rotary Club, St. John's Church, the Fall Fair, and Christmas performances. He spent 17 days in Africa as part of the Journey of Hope, where he taught English, geography, and physical education at 4 different schools. As part of his service for this project, he raised funds that were donated to help provide clean water tanks, improved cookhouses and latrines at the schools, support lunch programs, and computer equipment. What is most impressive, and not surprising at all if you know him, is his personality and his attitude. Spencer Watson, this year's outstanding youth, is the kind of person who is friends with everyone, always supportive, willing to teach, share, and cheer on others. Spencer constantly strives to excel, to learn more, do more, and to help more. He expresses his community spirit with such pride and humility. He is a consummate role model, living and acting to be the change he wants to see in the world. Congratulations, Spencer. Please come up and accept your award.
Thank you very much for that. That was very nice. Thank you. First off, I would like to say thank you to everyone who nominated me for this award. It's a great honor to be here receiving it today. I also think I owe a big thanks to my good friends and family, especially my parents, because they've been such good role models with everything they do in the community and at home. So it gives me somebody to look up to, and it helps me strive to be the best person that I can be. So thank you, Mom and Dad and family. I also know there are many other youth in the community who have done and do many outstanding things. So I'd also like to acknowledge all of their efforts and contributions to the community. Some of them may have even done more than me, but didn't get the chance to be nominated or selected for this award. So I'd just like to acknowledge all of their efforts as well. But once again, thank you to everyone who nominated me. It's a great honor to be here, and I'm very grateful to be receiving this award and having this privilege. So thank you.
Congratulations again. Our 2019 Outstanding Citizen adopted volunteering as a way of life, a way of cultivating and nurturing community, and it has continued for decades. In the mid-70s, our recipient was a certified Girl Guide leader and spent many Saturday mornings at the recycling depot sorting donations for processing. She was a member of the Yearbook Club and served as a candy striper at the Port Hope and District Hospital. In the 80s, she was assistant coach for the Port Hope Girls Softball Association and a convener for 18 teams from Grafton to Kendall. Throughout the 90s and into the early 2000s, she was a proud member of the Port Hope Connect Club. She held various active positions such as membership chair, secretary, and treasurer. She also helped organize the Christmas General Store and bingo nights for many consecutive years. A few years after taking on the role of deputy governor, a position responsible for overseeing 9 regional Connect Clubs, she received the Deputy Governor of the Year Award. She served on the Port Hope and District Chamber of Commerce Board from 1997 to 2003 and was president for 4 of those years. She worked on the Business Excellence Awards and helped initiate the ever-popular Taste of Port Hope event. For more than 20 years, she held an extensive list of positions with the Port Hope Legion, Branch 30, including Vice President, Chair of the Remembrance Day Parade, and Special Events Coordinator. And was she ever an engaged events coordinator, planning card tournaments, meat spins, patio parties, anniversary celebrations, and fundraisers galore. For her service with the Legion, she received the Legionnaire of the Year Award and the Paul Harris Award. Over the same 20 years, she was also the chair of the Candlelight Christmas Committee. This much-loved event was bigger and brighter every year due to her fundraising and coordinating efforts. She still manages the design, production, and distribution of the annual Christmas tile. This tradition is ongoing because of the devotion of our recipient. For the past 10 years, she served as chair and treasurer of the Port Hope Santa Claus Parade Committee, where she hosted monthly dinner meetings for the planning committee. She is a current and active member of Northumberland Sunrise, and you won't be surprised to learn that she has held some multiple positions within this organization as well. Some of her many efforts include coordinating a fundraising drive that resulted in 400 bags of flour being shipped to northern communities, organizing the summer concert Bandshell Free Community Barbecues, and serving as a membership chair for Men Who Cook, Women Who Sizzle. Our recipient, Karen O'Hara, is a well-known, well-respected Port Hope resident who has made many impacts to this community through her decades of volunteer service. The selection of examples listed above barely covers her extensive resume of volunteer roles. Karen is a connector and a creator. She is known for her giant smile, exceptional organization, and consistent follow-through. Come up and receive your well-deserved award, Karen. Karen Herron, our 2019 Outstanding Citizen.
Thank you, York. Good evening, Mayor Sanderson, members of Council, the Civic Awards Committee, staff, media, family, and friends. First of all, I would like to congratulate Spencer. You are a tough act to follow, and I wish you all the very best. It is truly an honor to be here tonight to receive this award, and it deserves to be shared with so many people, fellow volunteers, friends and family, past, present, and future. The very best part of being involved in our beautiful community is the incredible people you meet along the way. Some of you are here tonight to help celebrate with me, and I thank you very much for that. Thank you to the Civic Awards Committee. This is an unprecedented time for all, and you've hit it on the nail, or the nail on the head. Very, very good job for organizing tonight. To everyone who supported and submitted my nomination, thank you so much. I am so very grateful. Thank you to Danny on the home front. He was always there for me. Load, unload, go here, go there. I really appreciate your support. And my little friend Sophia, she's always very good to lend a hand also. Ladies and gentlemen, friends, Hollywood has their awards, the Grammys, the Tonys, and the Emmys. From the bottom of my heart, this is my Emmy, Port Hope style. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And a very special congratulations, Karen, Spencer, very, very well deserved, as we all just heard. And it's so nice to see your family and friends with you that are able to take part and see this honor that you so richly deserve. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again, Karen and Spencer. I would now like to turn things over to Mayor Bob Sanderson for some final words.
Thank you, York. And congratulations once again to our 2019 Civic Award recipients. I am honored to be part of this unique and vibrant community and very fortunate as mayor to have had the opportunity to work alongside so many of you. Your passion, dedication, and energy are second to none, and I'm delighted that your contributions have been recognized this evening. To echo sentiments from earlier tonight, volunteers really are the bedrock of our community, working tirelessly to improve many facets of community life for everyone who lives here. If you were nominated to receive an award, please consider paying it forward by nominating someone next year. Our community has so many unsung heroes, and these awards offer a great opportunity to say a special word of thanks for all their efforts. With that said, our sincerest thanks go out to the Civic Awards Committee for all their work in organizing this modified Civic Awards ceremony. It's been a necessary evolution this year, and I know it takes a great deal of coordination behind the scenes to make everything run so smoothly.
Thank you, Mayor Sanderson. The work, generosity, achievements, and impacts of all the recipients awarded here tonight are seen and felt throughout our community. Your passion, your action, your willingness to share gives this town so much life. Thank you very much.